It's time to enter the world of real estate in Oahu with Hawaii's only true real estate radio show, the Team Lally Real Estate Show. Grab a pen and get ready to take notes. For the next full hour, Hawaii's premier real estate leader, Adrienne Lally, and Attilio Leonardi will bring you the latest in real estate news and real-world strategies on how they can guarantee to sell your home at a price and deadline you agree to, or they'll buy it. Now, here are your hosts, Adrienne and Attilio.
Welcome to the Team Lally Real Estate Show, home of the Guaranteed Sold program, or we'll buy it. If you have any questions, just give us a call at 799-9596 or check us out online at teamlally.com.
Hey, everybody, this is Attilio. And we are going to be talking about, you know, I want to talk about, we'll talk about it a little bit right now, and then we're going to talk about it a little bit more
later
during the show. But I want to talk about 3D virtual tours. 3D virtual tours have become something critically important to today's, you know, anytime you're selling anything on the internet where you have to have, or anytime you're selling anything in the world where you have to have people come and take a look at it, 3D tours are becoming very important. I even heard that, you know, it's makes sense in real estate, but I heard that they're even using these this format for like museums, right? Where now you can go and tour the museum with the newer 3D tour. And
I think that we even have on our website, we have some links to some of those museum tours as well. I think that was very innovative for the museums to go ahead and put that in place.
Yeah. So I'll just, you know, I'll talk about the five things that, five benefits of having a 3D tour on your piece of real estate. But more importantly, well, what do we know about all of our listings and 3D tours?
Well, they have the 3D tour, the 3D Matterport tour. You can click through and virtually look at any one of our listings.
Yeah.
And there's even a button on teamlally.com. There's a button for the 3D tour.
What does the button say?
It says 3D tour. So you just click on the button. And
we're like showing the window.
Oh.
What are we showing the window for?
I don't know.
People are getting seasick looking at us on Facebook right now. But I'll continue the conversation regarding 3D tours. So if you go to teamlally.com, there's a blue button that says 3D tours. You just click on it. It takes you to the page with all of our listings. And on every single listing, there's another hyperlink that says 3D tour. And you click on it, and it's actually going to take you to what's called the 3-in-1. And what they mean by that 3-in-1 is that, one, it's going to have a YouTube video tour.
Mm-hmm.
Number two, it's going to have a Matterport 3D tour, and then all the photos in a really large format. But most importantly is those 3D tours. So we have two cameras that we own. They're about $3,000 a piece, and the second one is just in case the first one breaks. And then we have somebody in-house that does that for us, because what's important is that everybody's wanting this done. Those cameras are on back order. The people that do the work are kind of backlogged. But
so time is of the essence.
Yeah, time is of the essence. Speaking of time of the essence, I'm going to cover these five things that are important for 3D tours probably after the first break, because right now we're going to bring on
Duke Kim Han.
He's the original D, as in Duke Kim Han.
Of Hawaii Pacific Property Management.
Yeah.
Who actually...
Yes, I am.
Yes. So we're super excited to have you guys on. You know, you've recently been recognized in a category called the best of.
Yeah.
For property management. So congratulations.
Yes.
Big congratulations on that.
Thank you. It was quite surprising. And the TV station told me that they were surprised too, because we had no idea.
Mm-hmm.
The other people had an idea, and had an opportunity to have their people vote.
Yes.
We had no idea because we didn't even know. And they said that because we were never nominated in that category, normally when those things happen, they usually tell you.
Yes.
We don't know. This is our first time for us.
Well, you just have a lot of happy.
7 years.
You just have a lot of happy clients that are excited to tell the world about, hey, this is the best property management company. I am not at all surprised about this.
Yeah.
Not at all.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you know, I can tell you that there's a test how you can tell if your property manager is a good property manager. And that is at Friday at 7 o'clock at night, mm-hmm. when the property manager gets a call that something's not working.
Yeah.
How do they handle that? Do they let the owner know? Do they go out and fix it themselves? Do they have somebody answering the phone? We pick up a big part of our business every year from property managers that have failed that test.
Yeah. They're all watching Netflix.
Or they don't have they don't have a system or process in place
to handle those after-hours service calls.
After-hours service calls account for 50% of our calls.
Wow.
And this year, I think we just did a count. We're at 605. That's 605 service calls that have come into our service department.
Yeah.
Yep. And 300 of those have come in either after hours or on the weekend.
So what
this is the reason so many people don't like to do property management.
Is that, and I think that, then that's a question that you're recommending, that if you guys are shopping around for property management companies, ask them, how do you handle after hours service calls? And see what the response is. What's our response? What's your response?
We have a system in place for people when they call in.
Yeah.
We have almost 24 hours. I do go to sleep from about 12 to 5 a.m.
Yeah.
Where, you know, sometimes when I open the phone up at 5 a.m. or 6 a.m. in the morning, there's calls waiting.
Yeah.
And so when we get on that, we put an emergency call out right away.
Yeah.
And we have our numbers listed on our website. So a lot of times, if a tenant really wants to reach us, they can reach us.
Yeah.
And not a problem.
And then do you guys also have on the website a way to, you know, put in the service request through the website as well?
Yeah, they're instructed in the very move-in process how to do a service call, and it's all done online.
Yeah.
We have a portal that they've gone, and they'll tell us, you know, that they have a problem, and the portal will send an email out to the owner and to the property manager and to me.
Nice.
And so in the morning, we look at our portal, and it usually is stacked up with service calls or thoughts or issues that the tenants have, and we deal with them that day. It's really important. So the second question that you need to ask your property management company is, if there's an eviction in my property, who pays for that?
Yeah.
Mm. Who pays for the eviction? Well, with Koi Pacific, we pay for that.
Wow.
We take full responsibility for the tenants we put in the units, and we take so much responsibility for it that we're willing to put our money where our mouth is.
Now, that's what I call complete ownership.
100%
right.
Ownership.
Yeah, 100% accountable.
If we put somebody in that passes the background check and passes the criminal check, passes the verifications, and they decide not to pay the rent one day, and there's an eviction process, which could cost up to $3,000 one time, then we pay for that.
You know, pay
the legal costs on your eviction.
And most people think, I'll save money because I'll just do it myself. But they end up spending 3 months doing it. So you multiply that times the rent. And they still, even though you're not even charging them for it, why would anybody not want to have a property management with an eviction guarantee? That doesn't make sense to me.
Nope.
There's many horror stories about property management.
Yeah.
And, you know, once you get in an investment property situation, all your expenses are a tax write-off. So why wouldn't you get somebody to manage your property for you and not worry about it?
That's like a great,
that's what we do.
It's such a great reassurance, you know, especially it's like you have insurance on your business that's working for you. And hey, we're going to take care of this. So now
And you know, people try to save money on the GE tax and then they screw that up.
Mm-hmm.
And then they have a GE tax problem. That the penalties are even higher this year than they were last year. And there's less interest.
Yeah.
There's penalty.
Mm-hmm.
There's all kinds of stuff for not filing your general excise tax income on your rent, which is 4.5%. So, you know, there's just so many things that we take care of. We're a one-stop shop for the owner.
Yeah.
Now, I've got a real quick question for you on, you know, like with so many people that are struggling with the unemployment and being out of work. You know, I would imagine that you'd have a high amount of people that are not paying the rents or unable to pay the rents. And I think that last week you had talked about Catholic Charities. Now,
Catholic Charities had millions of extra dollars to use, and they sent out a blanket email to all the property management companies that have, you know, large amount of properties.
Yeah.
And so we sent it out to the Board of Realtors, and we sent it out to our tenants that are having... We only have a couple tenants that are struggling, but one of them signed up for that grant, and I believe they got some money.
That's awesome.
Yeah, helps with deposits, rent. Yeah.
That's right.
That's what it's there for.
Charities is one of the one-stop shops for our tenants to go to. So they do all kinds of like Attila just said, they help you with your security deposit. They help you with your rent. They help you with moving people in and out. They have a truck. that helps people move. They're amazing. It's just so amazing. That does that for charity.
They provide counseling, and I'm not talking like if you got drug addictions, which they do, but let's say just with all this home sheltering and all the stress of this COVID, you just need somebody to talk to. You don't have to have any other challenges, but that, hey, we're in an upside down world and need somebody to talk to, a professional. They can help you with that too.
So like I noticed when I was trying to do some research, I had Googled Catholic Charities Hawaii and rental assistance, and the link came right up, and it's very...
very easy to find.
Very easy, very user-friendly. So if any of our listeners are having trouble or know someone who's having trouble, please reach out to Catholic Charities and let them help you.
And
so listen to this. This is the worst part about this. If they don't use it, the Catholic Charities loses it.
Oh, wow. That's terrible.
Yeah.
Maybe some government money in there. Yeah.
There's money that has to be spent. Has to be.
Yeah.
Or else it gets taken away after a certain date. And I think that it's after August.
After August, okay. So people,
just a few more days.
You know somebody that needs help, just Google Catholic Charities for that.
A rental assistance program. It'll come right up. Yeah. Apply.
You know, the...
awesome.
Duke, there was two other things I wanted to mention on your behalf. One, you got this thing called these videos that you do, and they're on your website. And what kind of things can people expect to see on these videos? And they're short, maybe like 1 to 3 minutes.
Yeah, we talk about all kinds of stuff. Like if you're going to do improvements on your house, what would be the best 2 improvements? That was my latest the short video.
Okay.
If you have a termite problem, how is that going to affect your rental income? If you have pests in your home and the tenants are complaining, hey, I got bugs everywhere. Whose cost is that? You know, we go over so many subjects. I think there's 75 videos on there that you can look at. And it's really not for profit. It's not profiting me at all. It's just more for
being
the
helpful.
Tenant and for the owner education. Absolutely.
And you're doing about one of those, one every week or one every other week?
One every 2 weeks we send them out. Yep. We send them out to the owners and then we put them on our website.
So first thing was the video. Second thing, coming up, we're going to be working on it, but these times that you come on our radio show to do these quick PM property management minutes, we're going to be working on working on adding that to the site too. If you miss something or you're like, oh, what did he say? You can go to his website.
Yep.
Go to the website. And what's that website?
Hear the tip again.
Yeah.
www.hipacificpm.com.
All right.
Add the PM in. Don't forget.
That's
put
right.
Put that PM in.
Put it in.
Thanks, Duke.
Thank you, Duke.
Talk to you soon. Thank you.
All right, so you can reach Duke and his team at 445-9223 or check them out online at hipacificpm.com.
So we were talking with Duke, and before Duke, we were talking about 3D virtual tours, and I was just about to share with you the 5 most important things that you need to know about it. But then Jody,
the mortgage genius
just called in. So we're going to stop again and we're going to go raise your mortgage IQ by talking to the mortgage genius, Jody from
Pacific Rim Mortgage.
Jody, you there?
I'm here.
What you got for us this week?
Oh, today I wanted to talk about the difference between interest rate and APR.
Yeah. Interest rate and APR. What does APR stand for?
Annual percentage rate.
Okay.
Okay.
So annual percentage rate is a figure that we have to include on our estimates that we're sending out. So they're on our estimates that we send out. You'll see a line item for interest rate.
Yeah.
But then usually under that, you'll see another line item for annual percentage rate or APR. And a lot of people, those numbers they differ. They're not the same. And so it's confusing because people will say, well, why is my APR higher than my interest rate? And so I thought it would be a good topic to cover. But basically the interest rate, also known as the contract rate, is the rate in which your monthly principal and interest payment is calculated off of.
Okay.
So the interest rate is a very important number because that's the rate in which you're paying back the money The APR, the annual percentage rate, takes some of the fees associated with the closing cost and adds that back in to the total amount being borrowed, and then re-amortizes that amount over 30 years, and that's how you get the APR.
So Jody, I've got a quick question. So with the APR...
Hey, you know what?
Yes.
If it's a quick question, you should just skip to just asking it.
Well, I have to set it up. I got to set the question up here. So some people choose to pay all their closing costs up front, and then others, they choose to have them rolled in. So how does that look like?
What's the pros and cons?
Or what does the APR look like when you pay it up front versus having it rolled in?
So the APR in a refinance, when you're rolling in your closing costs, it will be higher than your contract rate, than your interest rate.
Gotcha.
If it's something like a government loan, like a VA or FHA or USDA, where we, the lender, and it's a purchase, and we, the lender, are paying for the closing costs, that's different than rolling it in. And that is where the APR will be equivalent to the interest rate.
Gotcha.
Because, you know, there's nothing to add back in and re-amortize over 30 years if the lender's paying for it.
You know, we talked about it on one of our morning huddles the other day, and it was the super low interest rates.
Oh, the teaser rates.
Yeah. So tell people about that, because everybody, they're just looking at the rates, but what's the rest of the story with these low rates?
So that's where APR does come into play.
Okay.
Because if you're paying points, you're going to notice that there is a bigger difference between your interest rate and your annual percentage rate if you're paying a lot of points. Because think about it. If you're borrowing $600,000 and you're paying 1 point, which is 1%, which is $6,000, now you're adding that back in and then re-amortizing that over 30 years. So that's how you can tell that your fees might be a little bit different. If you're comparing lenders and both lenders are giving you a, you know, 2.5, but one APR is 2.7 and the other APR is 2.6, that should be an indicator that the 2.6 APR lender is charging you less.
So if you want to know where you are, look at the APR.
That's right.
And you know why? Because it rhymes.
That's right. And then,
you know, stuff that, you know, you want to figure stuff out in life, as long as it rhymes, it makes sense. It's okay. No.
Well, the other thing too is you can just call Jody because she's the mortgage genius and she'll explain it to you if you're getting a good deal. Or, you know what? If they can do better. So that would be my advice on this whole tip of the week from Jody.
If you want to know where you are, look at the APR.
There you go.
That's it.
Mic 20, it up.
You can use that one time for 25 cents royalty fee back to me. All uses thereafter are completely free. All right, Jody. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Jody.
You're welcome. Bye.
All right.
Okay, so you can get a hold of Jody and her team at 488-5510. Again, that's 488-5510. Check them out online at packrimmtg.com.
All right. So 3D tours. This is like the third time I think we were talking about it.
You just keep getting interrupted.
3D tours. So, you know, a good way to look at that, you know, you can look at a picture of a turtle or you can go see one turtle. What would you prefer? What's going to give you a better sense of what that turtle is about? Looking at a turtle in life or looking at a picture of one?
In real life?
Yeah. So kind of like, you know, that's what we're doing with real estate. We're showing you the two-dimensional picture of the turtle, but we're not, you know, some of these pictures are really nice, wide angle, well lit. Still, it's a two-dimensional format.
And they can be deceiving.
Yeah.
Also.
So, couple things with this 3D tours that we do. Again, on all of our listings, some of our listings, or most of them?
They all have a 3D tour.
All of them go on 3D tour.
You just click on the button on our website on teamlally.com and start touring away.
So number one, it's like having an open house 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. So when you're up late at night, rewatching like The Walking Dead, like you went all the way back to season one and you're going to go all the way through to season nine. And you binge watching The Walking Dead, you get this chicken skin feeling on the back of your neck. You're like, what is that? It's not the zombie apocalypse that you're watching on the TV show. It's somebody looking at your home, if you listed it with us, with the 3D tour. Because with the 3D tour, here's the picture I'll paint for the mind's eye of radio, is that just imagine you using a mouse to go into a room and you can look at literally the walls, the ceiling, the floor.
Mm-hmm.
Complete 360 degree view.
And you can even, there's a little tool in there where you can measure the size of the room and see, hey, will my couch fit there? Can I hang my big screen TV?
So number one, it's like having an open house 24/7. Your potential buyers can view your listings anytime and at their own pace. Mm-hmm. Don't you, when you go like an open house or a showing, you're like, oh, I just want to sit here for a little bit and see what it feels like to live in this home. Well, you can take your time with a 3D virtual tour. Number two, you and your sellers can avoid getting exposed to COVID-19 or any other types of viruses.
There you go. Less exposure. Less exposure. Risk. Less risk.
One kind of virus you might be exposed to, maybe one computer virus, because you're going to have to use your computer or your phone to take a look at these 3D tours. So that's number two. Number three, if you're a seller, you know, we've had this before where we have all these commerce, you know, a lot of times we've been guilty of it, but buyer's agents or agents in general, they want to seem like they're busy. Mm-hmm. And what they'll do is like somebody will call you up. Yeah. Oh, I want to take a look at this house. First, I want to go to Kaneohe. Then I want to go to the North Shore, kind of near where Polynesian Culture Center is.
Mm-hmm.
And then I want to go out, you know, Haleiwa, kind of like where Sunset Beach is. You know what that's called? That's not being a realtor. That's called somebody calling you up to be tour guide. They want to take a look at all these homes. And then, can you take me to Kailua, kind of that place where President Obama gets shaved ice? I want to look at some homes over there. That's called a tour guide. And a lot of times, we're guilty of it. We're taking people to look at homes. One, they're not even qualified at that price point.
Mm-hmm.
They're not a serious buyer. And we feel like we're just busy. And then, how many times does it happen? You go through all this hassle, especially with the pandemic. You get them in the door and they're like, oh, I don't like the way this kitchen's laid out. We're out of here. Well, with the 3D tours, for you as a seller, it helps avoiding getting, allows the buyers to narrow down their search. And for you as a seller, you're not just having all these rando people coming in there.
The other thing that we have found, and especially right now, we have had quite a few homes that have been sold sight unseen. With buyers that are
Physical site,
yes,
not 3D tour site.
Yeah, they haven't physically walked through the home, so they've been able to close on these homes with the 3D tours.
Shouldn't be sight unseen. Then, it should be visit unseen.
Okay, visit unseen.
Visit unvisited.
I guess that's just like a real estate jargon.
Because we say sight unseen. Yep. You guys say visited unvisited.
They did not physically visit the property before closing on it because
they'll be like visited, not physically visited.
Yes. Yeah. Because the amount of information and detail that we're able to provide, and especially through the 3D tours, they feel confident in knowing what it is that they're going to be purchasing. And then they just arrive here and then they can quarantine in their brand new home. So
in fact, we've got,
we've had that happen a few times.
We've got a 4,000 square foot home, multi-level, very high price point. And this buyer most likely, because of the 14-day quarantine, is going to close on this thing.
Before
without physically walking through it. But because of the technology, they're feeling comfortable moving forward on that. Number four, it's perfect for condos or any of those associations where the home's located or the condo's located where you cannot put a for sale sign up. Perfect, because people can still check it out.
That's right.
Without visiting it. Number five, if it's tenant occupied.
Oh, yes.
You don't bug the heck out of the tenant.
We had another one.
Yeah.
Again. And yet another success story. So this property was tenant occupied, and the owners, like, they had made a promise to the tenants that they would not sell the property from underneath them.
Yeah.
And we were able to get the home on the market. No showings, did not disrupt the tenant at all, and got an over-asking price offer on this property using the 3D technology and the video tours.
Yeah.
So the first time that these buyers actually were able to physically walk through their home was at their home inspection.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I mean, this works very well for tenants. You want to keep the tenants happy and safe and, you know, get the home exposed properly with the marketing, and, you know, it'll be a win-win for everybody involved.
So speaking of 3D virtual tours, we're doing somewhere between 6 and 8 of them every weekend.
Mm-hmm.
Again, just go to teamlally.com. You can go to Team Lally Real Estate Facebook, and you'll see the events. You want to like
reminded.
Our page and get reminded.
No, just get reminded every time we go live.
So typically, they're done somewhere between 2 and 5 on a Sunday, and we're going about every 15 minutes to different homes, and we're zooming all over the island. And you guys, so some of these, most of these will have a physical agent on the ground, walking through the home with their phone and showing us the video of the home. And then Adrian and I are overlapping them with a virtual tour on, I think, what is it, Facebook and YouTube.
Yep.
Live. And then some of them, there's no physical person walking through, but we're still taking you through the home with the 3D Matterport. And Adrian mentioned it earlier, you know, in the bottom left corner. By the way, this is not special for realtors. And you don't need, and even if you're special, you can still use it.
Mm-hmm.
But there's a little tool in the bottom left corner. It looks like a ruler. Click on it. And you can actually measure, as Adrian mentioned, the length and width, the height, the depth. So you can really, to the inch, get an idea of what the dimensions are of a floor, a wall, a ceiling, any of that stuff. So pretty cool with this technology nowadays. You know, it's and was this technology that just came about because of the pandemic?
No, it's actually been in place for several years, and our team has actively been using it, and it just so happened that this has been a very useful tool for our sellers and buyers during this, you know, during the pandemic and keeping everyone safe, right? So
a couple interesting things I want to share with you before we maybe go on a break, or unless you got something else. Do we have anybody commenting, or anybody got a question out there in La La Land? I just, you know, wherever you're not, where I'm at, I call that La La Land. So whether it's Facebook world,
we've got
some other place on the planet.
We got Tony Madrona.
Tony Madrona. Hey, Tony.
Aloha, Tony.
Aloha, Tony. You know, that's his name, Aloha, Tony. He's really friendly and nice guy. He's got a great personality. I've known him for a long time.
He is Mr. Aloha.
He is.
That's,
so
thank you for tuning in, Tony.
Thank you for tuning in, Tony.
You rock.
Statistics, you know, people are wondering what's happening with the real estate market with this pandemic, COVID-19, all of that good stuff. Well, you know, we can make our anecdotal, we can share with you anecdotal what our opinion is on what's happening with the real estate market, which we have. I mean, we're very confident that if you need to buy or sell right now, we've got safety protocols, 3D tours, smart marketing, virtual tours, virtual opens.
Mm-hmm.
We've got all this new technology that we've been using and are making better and adapting for the new situation to help you get those homes sold. But here are the stats. Forget about my anecdotal stuff. So April, median sale price was about $809,000 for a single family home on Oahu. May, $797,000, going down a little bit. And then June, $770,000. But here's what I will tell you. So that's the median sale price between all of the homes, smack dab in the middle, 50% of the homes sold for above it, 50% sold for below it. So when you see that number, you're thinking, whoa, prices of single-family homes are coming down. Now, here's what we know from being in the trenches. We've got a coming soon coming up in, what was the name of that neighborhood? Terraza?
Yes, in Eva Gentry.
In Eva Gentry. And I'll tell you right now, we're looking at the inventory, which is like hardly anything.
Mm-hmm.
And we know for a fact that when we get this home all macked out, are we going to be selling it for less than what the last one sold, more for what the last one sold, or about the same? What do you think? What's your prediction?
Well, as long as the inventory remains as it is, I would say more. And also the homeowner does have a little work to do on the home. So,
but if the home is perfect, in perfect condition, we've got one coming up in Terraza. And I wanted to talk about that one and then two other ones. For our coming soon inventory, because I tell you right now, the buyers, by the way, we do this coming soon marketing program.
Yes.
And it's a new category that was put in by multiple listing service by Honolulu Board of Realtors. And it basically says you can put one, you can put plenty of pictures in the price and all of that. But we put in one picture, no price. and we don't allow any showings. And then we just, and it only goes out to the realtors. So if you want to know about our coming soon inventory, you might want to give us a call, because we have, I looked on our spreadsheet the other day, we have somewhere between 12 and 15 of these coming soon properties.
Mm-hmm. We also will usually put a sign in front of the house with the rider, coming soon. So
no, it says coming soon, and then it says duh on the end. Coming soon, duh. No, we don't have the duh on the end.
No.
And stuff. And so what that coming soon means is that we're in the process of getting it ready. Mm-hmm. But if you're a seller out there and you want to run parallel marketing to you getting the home ready for sale,
we can do
to
that.
To see how the market's reacting. What'd you say?
So we can do that.
We can do that.
We can do that.
We can do that. So
the other interesting thing that we did was we did like some little teasers on Facebook. We did a coming soon virtual open house and just started talking about the location of the property, the benefits, and just to, you know, get people excited about this new home coming to market.
Yeah.
So do you want to mention a couple of our other areas that we...
Yeah, we got one up in St. Louis.
St. Louis Heights.
St. Louis Heights. That's it's a coming soon situation. And that one's a pretty sizable home with a beautiful view.
Beautiful views.
All of downtown Honolulu. Mm-hmm. And so that's a coming soon coming your way.
There's one in Mililani also that's on a cul-de-sac. And
I feel like I should do it like a voiceover.
Oh, yeah. Go for it.
This home raised many people throughout the years. It made people cry, laugh, and scream. Now, this home is being... This home is being brought to you.
So the owners of this home actually had been in there for like 50 years. And they absolutely love... There's so much love that comes out of this home. Like when we walk through, you could just feel it. So it's on a cul-de-sac. It's pretty much all one level. And then they have a second master on the second floor. So it's a very unique floor plan with skylights and
Lots of natural lighting.
Indoor, outdoor living. The type of architecture that you see in this home, it's definitely something that you're not seeing these days. So it's high vaulted ceilings.
Like I said, lots of natural light. Mm-hmm. They've got a koi pond with actual koi in it. The backyard feels like you're in the middle of a rainforest, even though you're in a, you know, an subdivision.
Over 8,000 square foot lot.
Suburban area.
Yeah. So it's really a very special property, and we are super, super excited to be bringing it to the market.
We've got one in Eva Beach, one in St. Louis Heights, one in Mililani. Were there more? I know there's more. I'm just trying to remember all of them because I forgot to bring the list.
Oh, there's one that's coming up in Kapolei.
Yeah.
I think that one's a 4-bedroom home as well. Yeah. So anyways, we do have quite a few. So if you're thinking about making a move, or you would like to get access to that coming soon inventory, give us a call.
Well, one of the sellers, I want to highlight their home for us today. It's going to be on Kekikane Loop.
And this is open this Sunday, right?
This is going to be open this Sunday from 2 to 5. Mm-hmm. We're also doing a virtual open. They've done recent price adjustments.
Yeah, this is a wonderful opportunity.
Yeah.
I mean, the home is so large and could be used as a multifamily or multi-generational, or just if you have a very large family, like this is the home for you.
Yeah, the second floor of the home's got a deck that goes the entire, or an outside lanai, the entire length of the upper second story. And from there, and the windows and everything, you can actually see the whole Ko'olau range. Really beautiful, especially when it's raining and all the waterfalls start activating. But this one's a 6-bedroom, 4.5-bath.
Mm-hmm.
Interior living square feet is, what is that, total? Should we give them the total? 45?
Give them the total.
It's 4,550.
Even has its own indoor gym.
Indoor gym.
Yep.
And it has boat parking or
shed.
If you have
parking.
One of those trucks that says Maui built, it's all lifted. Mm-hmm. It has one of those types of parking. As well as the owners have a truck, and the truck is pretty, it's not a lifted truck, but it does fit within
the
carport.
It's a high clearance vehicle. So it does fit in the carport.
This one, 2003 Toyota Tacoma. The bugger is cherry. As Joe Coy would say. Anyway, I think it's a Ford or Chevy. Anyway, that's going to be in Kaneohe. 45443 Kekikane Loop.
Mm-hmm.
That's in Kaneohe. I think the new adjusted price is going to be $1,080,000.
That's right.
Yeah.
That is it is a great opportunity. So I think that this one's not going to be, it's not going to be available after this weekend.
I'm pretty confident that we're going to probably get some offers coming in the following week after this. By the way, I just noticed, I forgot I had this sheet on here, but the Hawaiian language, the word kane ohi means bamboo man.
Bamboo man.
According to
an
ancient,
I did not know that.
According to an ancient Hawaiian story, a local woman compared her husband's cruelty to the sharp edge of cutting bamboo. Thus, the place was named kane ohi or bamboo man.
Okay.
That's it. Now you know more.
On that note, I think we should take a short break.
Yeah.
All right.
Because, we're so dedicated to this show. The air conditioning is broken. And if you guys are watching on Facebook Live, I'm wearing an undershirt plus a long sleeve shirt. It's hot in here. But we're dedicated. We're dedicated to bring the show to you.
Stay with us.
A couple of things just to keep in mind. One, as things start to open up, you might be thinking of starting the process of buying or selling a home. Definitely need to give Adrian and Attilio of Team Lally a call. Now, what they're going to do is give you the advice and help you need to make the best decision for your situation without any pressure. An example would be Joy Zimmerman was looking to maximize her investment by having Team Lally's marketing sell her Kunia home for top dollar. Adrienne and Attilio turned on their marketing with their huge database of buyers, sold over ask for an amazing $650,000. Joy's pretty happy about that, too. Adrienne Lally, Attilio Leonardi, Team Lally Real Estate Group, Keller Williams, Honolulu. Confident in their marketing strategy, they guarantee to sell your home at a price and deadline you agree to, or they're going to buy it. Life can change very quickly, so if necessary, they will let you out of the contract at any time. More reasons to call Adrian and Attilio at 799-9596, 799-9596, or online at teamlally.com. That's teamlally.com.
Hey, it's Sean Hannity here, and I know the business climate has changed dramatically, but if you need to sell your home, don't believe the myth that homes aren't selling. Joining me now is a true expert at selling homes, Adrian Lally and Attilio Leonardi of Team Lally Real Estate Group of Keller Williams, Honolulu. So what's your advice on selling a home right now?
Sean, our real estate team has always been on the cutting edge with technology. We're using FaceTime for showing homes with buyers and keeping our buyers and sellers safe with a virtual showing at any time and any place. We've sold hundreds of homes this way.
So what does that mean for sellers?
Sean, ignore the fake news. This is an incredible opportunity for sellers. Supply has plummeted. Demand has skyrocketed. People still have to move. We have thousands of motivated buyers ready to buy. We eliminate the tire kickers, conduct the virtual showing safely, quickly, and conveniently to sell their homes.
All right, thanks so much. Look, talk to the agent that I trust for the best advice. Call Team Lally now at 799-9596. Online at 808GuaranteedSale.com.
Hi, I'm Barbara Corcoran. I hope every family will stay healthy and safe during these uncertain times. Our real estate market is experiencing many challenges every day. If you're planning to move or sell your home now, be sure to get the most current information from the best agent in your marketplace. In Honolulu, you should call Adrian Lally and Attilio Leonardi. You'll need an agent who is trusted in your community and understands your needs. Go online or call, and please stay safe.
Aloha, all our friends in Hawaii. This is Adrian.
And Attilio of Team Lally.
We know many need to move and have a lot of questions.
Don't worry. Modern technology has made the selling process easy, so you don't need to ever meet the buyer.
Homes are selling, and we're going to get through this.
If you need any advice on home repairs, about your home, or your mortgage, we're happy to help.
Go to our resource page at teamlally.com/COVID-19.
Be safe and aloha.
The Team Lally Real Estate Show continues.
Give it to me, I'm worth it. Baby, I'm worth it. Welcome back, and thanks for listening to the Team Lally Real Estate Show, home of the Guaranteed Sold program, where we'll buy it. I'm Adrian.
And I'm very hot and sweaty in the studio. And my name is Attilio.
Yes, and if you have any questions, just give us a call at 799-9596, or you can check us out on teamlally.com.
All right. So speaking of unexpected situations that may occur, and you'll be glad you got insured, we got Bradley from Allstate Insurance on the line. Bradley, what you got for us this week?
All right. So we have a tropical storm coming. If you are close at getting into escrow or you need insurance, now is the time to act and contact your insurance carrier, because moratoriums are going to start going out. Moratorium means, yeah, that we, all the insurance companies will stop writing home, cars, condos, renter's insurance, and hurricane insurance. So if you are getting close to that closing, you may want to contact your insurance carrier to see if you can secure some insurance prior to that moratorium.
So Bradley, if they miss it, this could delay closing, right, until after the storm has blown over, right?
Absolutely, yeah. Because they usually keep that moratorium 72 hours after the storm passes.
Yeah. So get your insurance in place.
Does this tropical storm have a name?
You know what? It does. I don't have...
I'm always curious about these names.
I'm so, yeah.
Who cares? That's the actual name of the storm name. Who cares? It's in the W range, right?
No.
We were... it's called Hurricane Douglas.
Oh, Hurricane Douglas.
I think they should get them local names like All Bus Up, Storm Inokea.
Well, this is like, I think, for, you know, the entire United States, not just Hawaii, right?
Oh, I thought it was Hawaii.
Kind of like blows.
I think people in the mainland would, okay. Yeah,
they'd appreciate like, that.
Susie from Tennessee. Hello there. We got Hurricane All Bus Up coming into town today. So I think they'd appreciate that. But, yeah, so moratoriums on the insurance. That's why. Do you guys get a lot of calls when Guy Hagi comes on the morning and says, "Oh, we got a hurricane coming in"? Do you get a lot of calls after that?
Yeah, that's when the phones go off the hook. People are wanting to make sure they got hurricane insurance if they didn't purchase it.
Yeah,
but if you don't have a mortgage, it's not required, so not everyone will take hurricane insurance.
Gotcha.
So yeah, it does get a little busier. My office will start calling mortgage companies to make sure that payments are in.
Mm-hmm.
If they're not in, so yeah, it's a busy time for us whenever there's a storm.
Yeah, you know, one of the things too we don't think about is like when you go ready to sell your home and it goes vacant. It's they need to notify you, right? If the home's vacant on the homeowner's insurance.
Yeah, it's good to let your carrier know, because there are some exclusions if it is vacant for more than 30,
yep.
Some companies 30, some 60.
Yep.
But there are carriers that will write these vacant homes. So important that you let people know if the house is vacant.
Yeah.
That is a good tip, because it's like you're not really thinking about that. You're like, oh, I'm going to sell my home. I'm headed to the mainland and it maybe is sitting vacant, right?
And then hurricane All Bus Up rolls in.
That's right.
And then you all sad.
Yeah.
Because you didn't call Bradley and update your insurance.
That's right. So make sure to update that insurance.
So.
And then what about like for the homeowners that this is their second home? The insurance companies usually knows that, right? Because there are a lot of
why? What they like? Santa Claus. They know when you're good and they know when you're bad.
Well, I mean, if this is your second home and because of the quarantine, it's like you're not coming to visit as frequently, right?
Gotcha.
So that would be something that's needing to be disclosed, right?
Yeah, so we do secondary homeowners as well as seasonal. What's important when the adjusters are calling, I did go through one of these, but if they see food, bedding, clothing in the home, that's all states consideration of what's vacant and versus non-vacant.
Oh, okay.
You go into a home and there's nothing in there,
mm-hmm.
and that's when they start considering that vacant.
Got it. So even if they're not like occupying the home, let's say that they're in California for 3-4 months, and then they come back, that's still considered occupied according to Allstate.
Yeah. So, but every claim is different. So I don't want, I want to put that disclaimer out there.
Yes.
But yes, typically when they interview the client, they're going to say, okay, when was the last time you were there?
Mm-hmm.
When they do go and inspect the home, they're looking to see if there is clothing, bedding, and so forth.
Okay, that's good to know. These are things that we don't really think
so,
about.
So, Bradley, I just
we do secondary residents.
Okay.
There are a lot of people that do go back and forth from California or from Colorado or Vegas,
mm-hmm.
back Vegas, and they come back here. So,
yeah,
we do secondary homeowners.
So, Bradley, with the information you shared with me today, I have come up with a song. You ready for the song?
Oh, you were just full of. You're just full of.
You better not pout. You better not cry. You better call Bradley to check on your insurance. Hurricane all bus up is coming to town. There's your song for today. I just made it up on the spot. Might be a little bit because I'm getting delirious because it's hot in the studio.
It is very hot.
But that's okay. We're having it. We're enjoying it. We're having fun with it.
Mm-hmm.
We get, as my friend from Miami would say, we're getting sweaty. But anyway, thank you, Bradley.
Thank you, Bradley. Excellent tip this week.
Okay.
Appreciate it.
Yeah.
Okay, so you can get a hold of Bradley and his team. Just call 591-8016. If you go to allstate.com, you can look him up under Maruyama and Associates. Now, he also does free reviews. And, you know, just to make sure that you're not overinsured or underinsured, you don't even need to have your insurance with Allstate. He will do that.
Check it out.
Yep, free of charge and let you know if you're good to go.
And they're going to give it to you straight. It's not some kind of sales ploy to get you to switch over.
No, Bradley's...
they're going to give it to you straight.
He is a straight shooter.
Straight shooter. And he has this thing called the moment of truth, so... You know, insurance, the best insurance is, you know, in reality, I've heard this phrase before, is the one you don't have to use. But when you do have to use it, you definitely want somebody like on the ground, local agent Bradley with his team, also dealing with the insurance company on a national level and fighting on your behalf.
And unfortunately, or fortunately, whatever you want to call it, we've had the moment of truth with him a couple of times with our business insurance. Mm-hmm. And I'll tell you, you know, not only is he wonderful, you know, for the home and auto, but for the business. It was a lifesaver.
Yeah.
So he showed up and, you know, it was all handled and the stress is gone because Bradley was involved.
Yeah.
So.
So I was going to share this in the beginning, but I was just coming through my notes and I wanted to share this with you right now because it's appropriate. You know, we're in a world of, we're in a world of crisis right now. We do have a pandemic that's rolling through the planet and, it's affecting everybody, you know, all industries, all businesses, all cultures, all language, all countries, cities, homes. And one of the things that we may as human beings let kind of slide a little bit when we're in a crisis situation is our empathy towards our fellow human beings, which in these times of crisis, is empathy more important?
I would say so.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How we're treating each other.
Mm-hmm.
So two important, I'm going to share with you here as we're coming down to the end of the show, and then we'll talk about some other announcements, but two important ways emotions can erode empathy. One is that we're caught up in a crisis situation, say like home sheltering or, you know, I know a crisis about a month ago was like, how can I get no toilet paper? And so
now there's plenty and hand sanitizer too.
Yeah. So, but here's what I would tell you: your ability to have empathy is easy when things are going your way, mm-hmm. or going right, or there's plenty toilet paper at Costco. But when you go week after week and there's no toilet paper, you start getting all stressed out, and maybe we're not as polite and or courteous to our fellow man. But so get out of your state of mind and have an self-awareness of how you're behaving,
mm-hmm.
but more importantly, what's going on around you.
I would say that usually when you see that kind of behavior, it's stemming from fear.
Yeah.
And in order to be empathetic, you have to try and figure out what are they afraid of? What is this fear? Right.
Or just being caught up in whatever it is that you're being caught up.
Yeah. So there's usually, but it's usually driven by some kind of a fear, right? And you got to be empathetic and sensitive to, you know, people's concerns and fears.
And being self-aware of what's going on. Situational awareness. So the example that I'm reading this article from, the person's had a real crisis call for their business and mm-hmm. they were getting on the train to go to work and they were just really deeply involved in this conversation. They're sitting on the commuter train. Old man gets on. He's got a cane, barely can walk. No seats available, so he's having to stand up. And everybody's giving the guy dirty looks because he's standing right next to him. The train, you know, jostles. The old man falls down. A lady catches him, puts him back up, and then he finally notices because he's so engrossed in his conversation that he must look like a jerk. And finally gives up his seat and has the old man standing down. To sit down. And so that's an example of how we get so engrossed and inward focused in our situation, we start losing our awareness of what's happening around us. And then that empathy
mm-hmm.
kind of goes to the backside, or it's just not there. And then number two, the second kind of, so that's when you're just so inside your mind, in your own state of mind, that you're not aware of the people around you that might need some empathy or some help. The second one is corrosive emotions. They build over time and result in corrosive emotions like bitter resentment, contempt, disgust. And that when we have these types of emotions inside our mind, it's really hard to be empathetic.
And
when you're resentful.
And I want to speak to that too. I think that when you're that way, and like you think that, you know, being that way, you're like punishing that person that you're so resentful of.
Yeah.
But really, it's you're affecting yourself and how you're being, right? Yeah. So you got to just let it go.
So from insights to action from mm-hmm. this person, it's important to understand the potential we all have for acts of short-term and long-term cruelty. We are human and emotional center, and each of our brains works similarly.
Mm-hmm.
By discovering that your frame of mind and your negative emotions, so those are the two things that we talk about that erode empathy, your frame of mind and your negative emotions can derail your empathy for people around you, you can begin to watch yourself and work to take proactive steps to avoid empathy erosion.
I would say that's no way to live. Like, yeah. You're not going to live a happy life or a long life. Right. Because I would say that those kinds of emotions and that kind of energy, it's not good for
your health. Well, it's repelling.
Yeah.
And it's not good for your health.
It's not good for your health.
And finally, you can also recognize when someone else is in a world of their own. So you can either steer clear, defend mm-hmm. yourself, or step in to protect another
mm-hmm.
in their path. And if you want to get more articles like this, super easy. Go to talentsmart.com.
Mm.
Talentsmart.com. It's free.
All right.
And it was short. It's only like 2 pages. And I was like, wow, that was a good takeaway.
We've got a couple minutes left in our hot box here at the radio station. And just want to leave you guys with this. We do have some open houses. We talked about them in the beginning.
Yep.
Just want to give you the website. So if you go to teamlallyopenhouse.com, openhomes.com?
It's teamlallyopenhouse.com.
Okay, teamlallyopenhouse.com. And you can see all of the homes that are going to be physically opened as well as the virtual ones. So please join us.
Yeah. And, you know, just like what Duke was doing with the videos for property management, we also are, I think we're trying to do about a video every week. Maybe.
We're doing one a week. I think we've been pretty consistent since March.
Yeah. So you can go to Team Lally, like our Team Lally Facebook. By the way, we also give away a secret word. We say a secret, mention a secret word on all our virtual opens. Collect 5 of the secret words. Send us a direct message.
And you will get a gift card.
You will get a gift card.
Everyone's a winner.
Everyone's a winner.
All right. So thank you for listening. And thank you to our sponsors.
Jody Tunga and Derek Tunga, Pacific Rim Mortgage.
Bradley Mariama of Allstate Insurance.
Kenji Ventetta with Pillar to Post Home Inspections.
Janice Merland of Dreamhouse Drafting.
John Speed with Kilauea Pest Control.
Duke Kim Han of Hawaii Pacific Property Management.
Thomas Sir Patterson of Patterson Land Surveying. If you want to get a hold of any of our sponsors, just go to teamlale.com.
We also want to give a big thank you to Leah Rodriguez, our producer here in the studio.
Woo-hoo!
Make sure to tune in next week. We'll have an awesome guest talking about something that'll change your life
forever. This is the Team Lally Real Estate Show, home of the guaranteed
sold program. If we can't sell your home at the agreed upon price and our time frame, we'll have it bought for cash.
Be safe and aloha.
The preceding program was sponsored by Team Lally.